In this question, we are having a derived class can call, one blank space is there, and constructor. We are having options like your void class constructor, or say base class constructor, default class constructor, and derived class constructor. So we are having four options are there. So we know that in case of single inheritance, we are having one super class. This super class can also be called as a base class. And we are having the subclass or the derived classes. So in case of single inheritance, we'll be having only one superclass or base class. We shall have one subclass or derived class. So now this derived class can call which class constructor? So answers are, options are four as I discussed. So now what will be the respective answer here? So let us consider this sample code here. We're having one base class. You can find that we have defined one class. The name of the class is base, and that is the base class here. It is having one variable. Under the public section, we have defined one constructor. Constructor is nothing but a method whose name will be same as that of the class name. And then here we're having this derived class. And this derived class is inheriting the base class. Here under this derived class, we're having one constructor. The name of the function will be derived. And here we're having the respective body here. Also, we're having another derived class constructor which is parameterized. So now here we are defining one object under the base class. We are defining one object under the derived class. That means calling non-parameterized constructor here. Here we are defining another object under the derived class, passing one parameter here. So if we execute my code, you can find that the code is running good. The compilation is okay. Now, if you run the code now, you can find that it is producing output like this. It is producing the required output like this. So now let me explain. So here we are having these outputs. So when we are calling this base class, we are defining this base class object, then you see the base class default, base default constructor is getting executed. Then we are calling this derived class object D1. Then you can find that the base class constructor is getting executed, and then derived default constructor is getting executed. Whenever you are calling this, the derived class object, we are defining one derived class object and calling the derived class parameterized constructor, then also the base default constructor is getting executed, and then derived parameterized constructor is getting executed. So now if we come back to our question, you can find that here we are having now, as an answer, we will be going for this option number B, because the base class constructor can be called from the derived class constructor. So that's why here we'll be going for the answer that is the base class. So my correct answer option number will be B.